Today, welcome to 12th English Flamingo, Chapter 6, Quills and Pancakes, is by Ashoka Mitran. Okay? Now, before I start hearing this whole story, we see that S.S. Vasan is the producer and he is addressed in the whole lesson. Pancake, as we know, is a brand name which is given to the makeup material brought to the Gemini studio in trucks loaded. Now let me just share with you a brief description about the author. Ashok Mitran is a Tamil writer and recounts his years at Gemini studio in his book, My Years with the Boss. So this whatever Ashok Mitran is talking about, this is the day he has passed with the Gemini studio that he is sharing with us. And what is that? This is an extract from the book My Years with the Boss, which talks of the influence of movies on every aspect of life in India. What is the effect of movies and in different aspects in the life of India, that is talked about. The Gemini Studios is located in Chennai, and when was it set up? In the year 1940. One of the most influential film producer organization of India in the earlier days was this Gemini Studio. And its founder, who was it? The producer, as we have told about, S.S. Vasan was the founder of the studio. And his duty of Ashoka Mitran in Gemini Studio was, he was just busy with cutting the newspaper clippings in different subjects and then file them up. Many of these had to be written out by hand. Sometimes the things were not visible properly, so Ashok Mitran had to write it by hand. But at the same time, he performed an insignificant function. He was the most well informed of all the members of the Gemini family. And this excerpt, what we are going to now read about or know about, is from the experience what Ashok Mitran had, and the name he had given, the extract is from his book, My Years with the Boss, that is S.S. Vasan. Pancake was the brand name of the makeup material, and Gemini Studio brought it in trucks load. So in a film industry, the actors and characters were to be, their makeup was to be done, and this makeup was brought in large quantity in trucks loaded. Greto Garbo must have used it. So here, writer is giving reference of few characters who must have used this branded makeup, and that is Greto Garbo, Miss Govar also must have used it, and Vajanti Mala, these are the famous name. But the recent newcomer, that is Rati Omikatri, must have not even heard of it. The makeup department of the Gemini Studio was where it was there, and it was a big building. Gemini Studio had a big building, and in the upstairs of that building, top floor, this studio was, this makeup department was. And earlier we have heard of Robert Clive's, that is the British ruler, one of the British ruler, and he had a stable earlier when British rule was there. Robert Clive's stable used to be there, right at present, where this makeup room or the Gemini studio is there. A dozen other buildings in the city are said to have been his residence. So, Robert Clive had to move from one place to another, and so many other residences were there in the city. For his brief life and as an even briefer stay in Madras, Clive seems to have done a lot of moving. So, he had a very short stay in Madras, but still he had moved to many places, and at the same time, so many other battles also in remote corners he had fought. And in course of his stay in India, he had married a maiden in the St. Mary's Church, which is in Fort St. George in Madras. The makeup room had the look of a hair cutting salon. How he now, Ashok Mitran is describing the makeup room. It was a big room, it looked like a saloon, and at the saloon, and at the same time, lots of flashlights were there, seen in that room with from different angles, and large mirrors were also there. And at the same time, they were all incandescent lights. Incandescent means shining lights were there, and everyone can imagine the fiery misery. Misery is distress. Fire is fire. Like it was hot everywhere. The bulbs were glowing, and they could feel of those subjected to makeup. Whosoever seated there would experience the fire-like misery or distress while sitting on for the makeup. The makeup department was first headed by a Bengali who became big for a studio and left. Okay? So initially, this makeup department was handled by a Bengali person, and then he became big means he felt proud that he is not fit for, his position is not fit for doing the makeup or in the studio. And that's why he left, and after him came a Maharashtrian, and then after him came a Darwal Kannadiga and Andhra Pradesh, and after that a Madras Indian Christian and Anglo-Burmese, and after that so many local Tamils also supported or succeeded him. All this shows that there was a great deal of national integration long before AIR is All India National Radio Broadcasting. Okay, All India Radio. So he's telling that this Gemini Studio, makeup man from different places, that is Maharashtra, Madras, Canada, Andhra Pradesh, all people from there came, and that's why he said that this place looked like that is the national integration is seen in that place. And more than what national integration All India Radio used to explain, more than that was seen in this studio. Okay? And after that, this gang of nationally integrated makeup men could turn any decent looking person into a hideous. Hideous means extremely crimson, ugly, huge monster, with the help of the truckloads of pancake and a number of other locally made potions and lotions. So he's saying that this gang, this full group of the makeup men, they could had a good creativity. What would they do? A decent looking person, by applying the makeup, that is this pancake, they can turn that man into a extremely ugly looking monster. And at the same time, the monster would be changed into a decent person also by applying potions also, or some sort of lotions or liquids which are applied while doing the makeup. Those were the days of mainly indoor shooting, and 5% of the film was shot outdoor. So hardly outdoor shooting was there, and that's why lots of makeup was done to these characters. I suppose the sets and studio lights needed the girls and boys to be made to look ugly in order to look presentable in the movie. So he's saying that in this set, whosoever entered, they would be ugly, and so only as the makeup is used, they would turn up to be presentable in the movie. A strict hierarchy was maintained in the makeup department. The chief makeup man made the chief actors and actresses. Saying that while doing the makeup, a state of hierarchy means a ranking according to the status was followed in this Gemini studio as far as makeup is concerned. And first the chief actors and actresses would be, for them the makeup would be done, then the senior assistant, the second hero, the junior assistant, the comedians, then the crowd of people, and so on. This way, turn wise the makeup was done. And even the makeup department, sometimes the office boy, this is sarcastically, the writer is saying that in a studio, that is not an office, but still the boy who is shouldering the responsibility, okay, this office boy also sometimes was given the responsibility to do the makeup of the people who were in the crowd, or whenever a scene is done with a group of people. On the days when there was a crowd shooting, you could see him mixing his paint in a giant vessel and slapping it on the crowd players, and the idea was to close every pore of the surface of the face. So they say sometimes when a scene is there, where a huge crowd was there, then this office boy would be found mixing this makeup in a big giant bowl, and then applying it on the players which were to participate in the crowd. And then the idea behind doing the makeup is there that any pimple mark or any cut marks or anything should be covered with the help of the makeup so that the characters look presentable in the movie. He wasn't exactly a boy. He was in his early 40s, having entered the studios years ago in the hope of becoming a star actor or a top screenwriter. He's saying that even though this man was so called office boy, actually he was in his 40s and he had with that intention to become an actor, entered the studio, but then hardly he got the chance and remained what? As a little lyric writer or as an office boy he was performing his duty. In those days I worked in a cubicle, two whole sides of which were French windows. Ashok Mittal is saying that in those days he was cubicle means in a small room he was seated, and the room had big French means large windows it had, and I didn't know at what time they were called French windows. The writer is Ashok Mittal is confused that why they were called French windows. He was not knowing. Seeing me sitting at my desk tearing up newspapers day in and day out, most people thought I was doing next to nothing. So we are told that Ashok Mittal's task was what? To cut the newspaper clippings and then file it up and sometimes write it by on his own handwriting also. So he used to be seen always tearing the papers and so on. So whosoever found him in that condition thought that he was just doing nothing. But he himself knew what task he was doing. So anyone who felt I should be given some occupation would barge into my cubicle and deliver an extended lecture. Say, anyone who thought that he is doing nothing, just sitting there, would enter his room without any intimation and then go and give him a big lecture. The boy in the makeup department had decided I should be enlightened on how great literary talent was being allowed to do this in a department fit only for barbers and perverts. Perverts are people who waste, whose behavior is not accepted. They are known as perverts. They saying that the makeup the boy who was there in the makeup department, he had decided that the writer should be enlightened and how great his literary work and so on. He only knew that, and otherwise the people were not giving importance. Soon I was praying for the crowd shooting all the time. Nothing short of it could save me from his stepping. So often the narrator would be waiting for the crowd shooting. In all instances of frustration, you will always find the anger directed towards a single person openly and covertly, and this man of the makeup department was convinced that all his woes, ignominy and neglect were due to Kotha Mangalam Shubhu. So he is saying that whenever the right characters over there in the movie were frustrated, so what would we see? They would all become angry and their anger would be expressed. This one word, wo means sorrows. Okay? And ignominy means what? Disgracing. They would be disgracing. That sort of attitude or behavior would be shown to whom? To only one character, and his name is Shubhu. Whole name is Kotha Mangalam Shubhu. There everyone would shout at him and express their anger or frustration. Shubhu was number 2 in the Gemini studio, and he couldn't have had a more encouraging opening in films than our grown-ups makeup boy had. So he tried, but he did not have a good opening. On the contrary, he must have had to face more uncertain and difficult times. So the makeup boy started more than him. This man had difficult times, and when he began his career, that is Shubhu. There were no firmly established film producing companies or studios. When Shubhu started, there were no good, well-known, well-established film companies or studios. Even in the matter of education, especially formal education, was only accepted. Shubhu couldn't have had an appreciable lead over our boy, but by virtue of being born a Brahmin, a virtue indeed, he must have had exposure to more affluent situations. He's saying that more than the office boy, Shubhu did not get any appreciable lead, but at the same time, why? Because he was a Brahmin, okay? He had some exposure, and in certain situations where and people, he had little bit had the ability to look cheerful at all the times, even after having had a hand in a flock of sheep. So you say, one benefit was there, because he was a Brahmin, always he had a smiling face, he was always cheerful. And that's why even if a film was flopped also, he never grumbled. He always had work for somebody. He was always ready to work for somebody. He could never do things on his own, but his sense of loyalty made him identify himself with his principal completely and turn his entire creativity to his principal's advantage. So he is saying that he was very loyal, and that is why he was always identified. That was his loyalty, was his identification, and always that is why this was his creativity, and that led him to the principal advantage. He was tailor-made for films. Here was a man who made could be inspired when commanded. The rats fights the tigers underwater and kills them, but takes pity on the cubs and tends them lovingly. So he's saying that he was a tailor-made for films. And here an example is given that here was a man who could be inspired when commanded. Was an inspiring personality. He's saying that, and when example or reference is giving, the rat fights the tigress underwater and kills her. But he's saying that when there is a fight between the rat and the tigress, at least underwater, the rat is bothered about the cubs and then he takes care of them lovingly. I don't know how to do the scene. The producer would say, and Shubhu would come out with four ways of rat pouring affection on his victim. Sometimes he's saying that Shubhu was of that quality. Shubhu had like that of a rat. That whenever any producer would come, that he is not able to do something or he is in problem and he cannot do the scene or anything, Shubhu will always have the alternative, and he would with full affection like the rat help the victim. Good, but I am not sure it is effective now. The producer would say, and in a minute, Shubhu would come out with a 14 more alternatives. Sometimes whatever options were given by Shubhu, if the producer would say that this will not work, then Shubhu would not be disheartened. He would again go with some other alternative. I mean, that shows that always ready to help others. And then if there was a Shubhu around, and if, so he is saying that filmmaking must have been and was so easy. And whatever problem was there in the film, if Shubhu is around, then all the problems would be solved. And that is why he said that he was a man who gave direction and definition to Gemini Studio during its golden years. And anyone who is Shubhu. Shubhu had a separate identity as a poet also, though he was certainly capable of more complex and higher thoughts. He said that, apart from that, helping others, Shubhu had a quality of as a poet, and he had the capability to do many complex tasks in a higher level. He deliberately chose there to address his poetry to the masses. Whenever he got time, he tried to tell his poetry whenever masses were there. His success in films overshadowed and dropped his literary achievements, or so his critic. And so he's saying that, but even though he was a poet, he was good at that, but as he succeeded in his film, the success in films was overshadowed. For he could not succeed much in the films, this part of his literary achievements also was not that glorious. Also, his critics felt he composed several truly original story poems in frog refrain and diction, and also wrote a sprawling novel, Thillana Mohanam Bar, with dozens of very briefly each character. So he was a versatile character, and he wrote a novel that is Thillana Mohanam Bar, and so many other poetries and flock reference also, and so many briefly each characters were there in his story. He quite successfully recreated the mood and manner of Devdasis of the early 20th century. So he's saying that he had that quality that whenever in the studio anyone was frustrated or thin, Shubhu had that quality that he would change the mood of the people. And in the 20th century, Devdasis used to do, and cheer by with the help of their dancing, they used to cheer the whole crowd. Thank you. Next part I continue.